So let's just talk about what is it to be human. What is it to be human? To be human is to be two and yet be one. To be human is to be body-mind. To be human is to be a person. At the same time, to be human is to be the source of all. To be human is to be these two. And to be human is to be one when these two are together. When the body mind are one with the source. If as a human being, you are just body mind, then you will be in for a lot of suffering. If as human you consider yourself to be just the source, then you are in for an equal dose of suffering. Because you are still meandering in thoughts. Because if you are thinking yourself to be source, you are still thinking. So
thought,
that is...
Thought became thought.
Yes.
Thought to itself.
So to be human is to be both at the same time, parallelly, simultaneously. I am very much a creature of flesh and blood, and I am at the same moment very much divine. That is what is it to be human. I am both. That which you can see, that which you can hear, touch, and that which cannot be touched, which cannot be heard, which is beyond all perception. I am both. And I am both at the same time. This is what is to be human. Getting it? To be human is to be both together and hence one. Now, to err is human. Yes, the body mind will err. They will do a lot of things which they will label as an error. They live in the domain of words where errors are always there. They live in the world of right and wrong, where something is proper and something is a mistake. So to err is human. All right, yes, of course. But it is more human to forgive. Let's just say it is completely human to forgive. When you are just one part, body, mind, then you live in the world of right and wrong morality. In that world, there are errors and property. This is proper, this is improper. This is not a mistake, this is a mistake. That is when you are just body mind. But when you are both body mind and the source together, then there is no error. Then there is no error. And hence there is no forgiving as well. Are you getting it? Challenge is not to become divine. The challenge is just to become fully human. We are not even fully human. But our arrogance is such that we'll never say, I want to become a human being. We'll say, I want to become divine. I want to go beyond humanness. Which is not a challenge at all, which is just a mental fabrication. The challenge is just to become fully human. And to become fully human is to have both these together, the body, mind, and the source. When both these are integrated, one with each other, immersed in union, that's when you are fully human. You live in the world of senses. And you live somewhere else as well. And these two are together. You are dancing on the soil. And you are dancing somewhere else as well. And these two are together. You are saying something. And you are deeply silent as well. And these two are happening together. This is what it is to be human. You are engaged in vigorous activity. and there is no action happening at the same time, at the same point. This is what it is to be human. Both together. Both and together. That is complete humanness.